All this service will be a complete, total waste. Though there's been an anointing here to preach and proclaim. Unless you come and pray. There's not a thing that's come through my clay lips by the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Ben. That's come through my clay lips by the Holy Ghost will ever become reality in your life unless you get up at this altar and begin to call on Him about it. Until you come and pray about it. Somebody say, you got to pray about it. Thank you, Holy Ghost. What you going to do? Somebody shout, if you'll turn it over, He'll turn it around. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Drop track six there, bro. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Praise God. Brother Marvin, I thought you'd come lay hands on me and be fixed. That's what Naaman thought. He went in 2 Kings 5 that Elijah would do for him. And Elijah told him to go down to the River Jordan and dip 7 times. He didn't do it at first. Because verse 11 said, behold, I thought. Come on, that's the quickest way to miss your miracle is to think. 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 Stop thinking and start praying. Come on, somebody. Come call on His name. Well, preacher, I ain't been filled with the Holy Ghost. I'm saved. I've been sanctified, best I know. Amen. God separated me from my sins and stuff, and I'm living a different life now, and I gave my life to Him. If you want to be full of the Holy Ghost, it ain't going to happen you sitting around thinking about it, hearing somebody preach about it. You're going to tap out of your seat and come call on His name. Come on, somebody. He fills people with His person and power. The more of God is accessed to those who call on Him. If you ain't got a prayer life, you better get you one. Come on, somebody, because nothing God's ever promised will ever be accessed except you pray, unless you call on Him. And let me tell you, you can't pray in the Spirit until you run out everything to pray in your flesh. Don't you dare come up here and pray and then you can't think of nothing else to pray and then you just leave. That's when you need to stay. That's what I'm trying to teach you. That's when you got to knock. Go ahead. Hallelujah. Let's see if that's it. Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Praise God. Yeah, that's it. Jesus said, I'm the door. There's a door here, there's a door there. You can walk out that door the same way you came in and out, or you can come up here where Jesus the door is, and enter in here and be changed. Come on. Be still, there is a healer. His love is deeper than sin. His mercy is unfailing. His arms a fortress for the weak. Let faith arise. Let faith arise. I lift my hands to believe again. You are my refuge. You are my strength. As I pour out my heart,
as I pour out my heart and pray these things, I remember.
goes out. I don't need to go afraid. Jesus understands what you're going through. He's been touched with every feeling that's touching you. Hey, hallelujah. He bore stripes upon his back. We're going side. So he could take your pain. Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Reach out and touch his garment. In Jesus' name. Jesus is your healer. His power is still the same. Digestive system. The Holy Ghost said, if you'll come stand in my honor tonight and lift your hands and call on me, you'll know I'm Jehovah Rapha, the Lord that healeth thee. Exodus 15:26. Come, if you're going to receive a healing, you got to come ask him. Come call on me. Hallelujah. Somebody's digestive issues, God will heal you right here. No matter where you are, the one who hears and sees. He's been touched with everything and feeling that's troubling thee. Just come and ask and believe. Surely the night is his honor you'll receive.
Proverbs 11:21.
Jesus,
let us hear.
Christ, living in you. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. You know, Lord, show me this. Holy Ghost told me he was going to touch you tonight when I was preaching. Thank you, Jesus. The Lord knows my heart while I was preaching. I said, oh God, don't let her leave before the altar. Holy Ghost. Thank you, Jesus. He's got his hand on her. Thank you, Jesus. God, thank you for what you did for her last night. Thank you for using her in this holiday, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. God, I declare them the Lord's ladies, women of God. Come stand right out here, little sister. God, fill her with your power. Fill her with your power, Holy Ghost. Fill her with your power. Here comes Holy Ghost. Of your life, you're going to find the Holy Ghost causing some people that you call friends right now, they're going to start going the other way. As he separates the godly for himself, Psalms 4:3. God put the right people. You see, evil communications corrupts good manners. That's 1 Corinthians 15:33. Amen. So, Holy Ghost, I pray that over. I pray the right people. The right people have the right voices, and right voices bring about right choices. Proverbs 6:3 said, humble yourself and make sure you're friends. Humble means pray. Jesus prayed all night in Luke 6:12 before he chose who was to hang with him in his prayer. Wow. That's a whole nother message. Thank you, Holy Ghost. You whisper. You child, and I will never let you go. I've come to worship you. Come on, let's worship him with this last song. I've come to praise your name. Saying my daughter and tell you it's the truth. They play films in her classroom and they're cursing it, and she gets up and walks out. Come on, somebody. There's a friend in Jesus, son. Hallelujah. Whoever's going to be a friend of God, friendship with the world, it wanes, it goes. Thank you, Holy Ghost. That don't mean you'll be alone. God put the right people in your life. Glory to proclaim, holy.
the righteous to be moved. Psalm 55:22. Casting all your cares upon him because he cares for you. 1 Peter 5:7. Holy Ghost, I thank you. This is lifted. This is down over her now. Yes, Lord, in presence, I will stay. Come on, somebody clap, shout.
Glory.
Leap, jump, bounce, skip, run, somersault, something, praise him somehow or another. Amen. He's worthy. He's worthy.